Let's work through an example that involves using area functions to find the area of various regions. Okay, so here we're given two area functions. It says let a of x equal the integral from negative 2 to x of f of t dt, and g of x equal the integral from 1 to x of f of t dt. Okay, so remember that the definite integral gives the net area under the curve, right? So for any x that we plug in, right, this is a function, a of x, and for some x that I plug in, it's going to give the net area under the curve on that interval for the function f of t dt. So my function f is shown here in this picture, and you can see that the area for various regions is shown. And then the instructions are, based on the graph shown, calculate the following. Okay, and then we have six things that we want to calculate here. Okay, so let's start with number one. In number one, we're supposed to calculate a of 1 and g of 1. Okay, so remember a of x equals this expression here, the integral from negative 2 to x of f of t dt. So if I'm calculating a of 1, okay, then I'm plugging in 1 for x, so then that's going to become the integral from negative 2 to 1 of f of t dt. Okay, now remember that notation once again is asking for the net area bounded by the curve on that interval. So if I look at my picture from negative 2 to 1, the net area there is just 7, right? The area bounded by the curve there is 7. So that's my answer, 7. Okay, and then we want to do, so that was a of 1. We want to do the same thing for g of 1. So g of 1, the function g of x, is given by the integral from 1 to x of f of t dt. So g of 1 means I'm going to plug in 1 for x. So then that's going to be the integral from 1 to 1 of f of t dt. So what does that equal? Well, remember the properties of integrals. If I have a definite integral that goes from a to a, okay, in other words, the lower bound and upper bound are the same number, then the value of that integral is 0. And that makes sense, right? Because the integral represents the net area under the curve, but from 1 to 1, there's no net area there, right? Because there's no region, just 1 to 1. Okay, so that's a of 1 and g of 1. So let's do the same thing now for a of 4 and g of 4. So still using my a of x area function, if I plug in 4 for x, it's going to be the integral from negative 2 to 4 of f of t dt. So now I want the net area bounded by the curve between negative 2 and 4. So let's look at the picture. Well, from negative 2 to 1, I've got this area of 7. Okay? That's going to be part of it. But then look, from 1 to 4, my region is below the axis and it has a total area of 16. But because it's below the axis, it's going to be a negative contribution to the net area. So then I'm going to end up with 7 minus 16, which is going to give me negative 9 as the net area from negative 2 to 4. All right, and then we can do g of 4. So I'm plugging in 4 for x in g of x, which is going to give me the integral from 1 to 4 of f of t dt. Okay, and if I look at my picture, 1 to 4, that's this 16 region, right, but it's below the axis, so now this is just going to be negative 16. All right, and finally we want to calculate a of 7 and g of 7. So once again, a of 7 means I'm plugging in 7 to a of x, and that means that I'm going to have the integral from negative 2 to 7 of f of t dt. Okay, so referencing my picture, I'm going all the way from negative 2 to 7. So first I've got this region that has a total area of 7, and it's positive. And then I have this area of 16, but it's below the axis, so minus 16. And then I have this area above the axis that has a total area of 12. Okay, so then that's going to be positive 12. Okay, so if I evaluate that, I get an overall net area of 3. And then finally, let's calculate g of 7. So now I'm plugging in 7 to g of x, which is going to be the integral from 1 to 7 of f of t dt. Okay, so it looks like I'm going to have negative 16 from that first region, and then plus 12, so negative 4 overall.